What's up, gamers? Welcome back to another Pro Guides video. My name is Cody, and today we're going to be doing a guide on how to consistently outplay your opponents in Fortnite. You might have seen some insane 200 IQ players like Mr. Savage constantly coming up with these insane plays that nobody else would have thought of. After this video, you'll know how to replicate this for yourself. To start, we'll go over a few of the general tips to outplay opponents, then we'll look at a few specific examples from Mr. Savage himself. Without further ado, let's get into the video. But real quick, before we get started, I've got a question for you. Are you looking to get better at Fortnite? If you are, make your way over to ProGuides.com where we have exclusive courses from our pro members made by pros like Mongrel and Benji, along with meta updates. On top of all this, we also offer 24/7 on-demand coaching from some of the world's top players. If any of this amazing stuff interests you, you've got to check out ProGuides.com. Last thing, before we get into this amazing video, let's do today's question of the day. What is your favorite 200 IQ play in the history of Fortnite? A few of my favorites are Mr. Savage's Shadow Bomb Clutch. Ooh, that was nice. Mitro Shockwave play. Epic. And the infamous World Cup Game 1 clutch by the man himself, Booga. Woo. Honestly, one of the main things I love about Fortnite is the amount of creativity involved. Seeing these 200 IQ plays being pulled off really inspires me to get better at the game. Let us know in the comments what your favorite 200 IQ play is. The first step to winning any fight and outplaying your opponent is to put yourself in a good position. Obviously, you don't want to be sitting on low ground with an opponent who has an RPG sitting above you. That's just common sense, and it's something most of us know by this point. A few of the positions you want to put yourself in are having high ground, better loot, and more materials. Having high ground is the simplest of the three, only requiring that you build up above your opponent using any sort of building techniques. Some opponents might be easier and only require a basic ramp rush to push over. And some might be crazy crankers who want to turn every fight into a build battle. However, if you can't push to height, the second option is to wait for them to overbuild and break them down. Most players you'll run into are overconfident in their building, and they build way too high. If you see the bottom of the structure is easy to break down, you can spam some floor and cones to cover your head and chop them down. Chances are, you'll either eliminate them or get an easy chance to push for the height while they fall. Geronimo, goodbye. The other two advantages, better loot and materials, all stem from the early game. Having a solid early game when you get full shields, good loot, and a lot of materials is absolutely crucial going into mid and end game, especially considering materials are so much more important in Chapter 2 with the lack of mobility. We recommend landing at any place with solid loot, typically above 6 or 7 chests if you're solo, or more if you can get it uncontested. These locations will give you enough loot with only a few people to fight who you can clear out quickly. Farming up throughout the game is also crucial, as you typically won't have enough materials right out of your spawn location, unless you got a lot of time to loot up. If you do all of these things, you'll be setting yourself up for success in your fights. In a lot of the fights you take, the winner is determined before the fight even starts, with someone having better loot, materials, and a high ground advantage. Essentially, what we're trying to say is that by setting yourself up for a better position before the battle even starts, that is gonna heavily improve your chances of winning the fight. By looting a good location in the early game, farming up materials as much as you can, and pushing for high ground at the start of every battle you get into, and breaking the opponent down if they overbuild, you will be setting yourself up for better fights, giving yourself plenty of advantages before they even begin. The second step to consistently outplaying your opponents is to watch pros fight. This is especially helpful if you're watching them in a high point tournament lobby or a high level scrim, as most of the players they're fighting are really, really good at the game. Analyzing these fights and seeing what they did and when they did it will give you a better understanding of what works and what doesn't, especially against good players. If you find a technique or trick that you don't already know, head into creative and try it for yourself. Practice this technique until you can do it consistently, then bring it into 1v1s and in-game to get more realistic practice with it. The real reason pros can pull off these 200 IQ plays is because they already know the tricks, whether it's through a fundamental understanding of certain game mechanics or if it's something they've practiced. In both cases, they've spotted a unique opportunity that they are using. Use it or lose it, dude! The last tip to outplay opponents is to understand game mechanics. This means understanding as much as possible about the game, including right-hand peeks, building and editing mechanics, and anything else you can think of. The more you know about the game itself, the more you'll be able to think of ways to abuse it. Understanding game mechanics honestly just comes from playing the game and fighting a lot. you'll naturally notice some patterns. We recommend doing 1v1s and box fights to really learn new mechanics and find ways to use the mechanics you already know to get an advantage. Now that we've gone over 3 tips to outplay your opponents, let's analyze a few clips of Savage making some 200 IQ plays so we can try and learn from them. To start it off, let's look at this insane play where the big brain legend himself pulls off an absolutely crazy 1v2 fight in potentially the worst situation you can get into. Roll the clip. Oh, wait, who am I talking to? Okay, I guess I gotta hit play. Where's the play button? Oh, here it is. All right. In this clip, Mr. Savage starts off in a pretty bad situation with a gray pistol, only 3 builds, and no shield. Aye, aye, aye. As if it couldn't get any worse for him, there's already a duo pushing to try and eliminate him off the spawn. Savage hears them on low ground and immediately pushes up so he has the high ground advantage when the fight is forced on him. Savage manages to tag one player for 24 white and places a wall just in time. So he knows one player is 76 HP or lower. He grabs a bit more material and pushes back a bit to see if there's any viable escape plan. Unfortunately, there's not. So he has to resort to waiting for the enemies to ambush him. Kinda spooky. But let's see what happens. One player starts pickaxing at his wall, and he manages to tag him for 24 on shield once the enemy takes it and edits through. Mr. Savage is collecting as much information as possible right now. He knows that one player is low on health, and the other has shields to spare. Interesting. He quickly gets his wall taken and ramps up and realizes there's no way out. Using the element of surprise, he jumps on one of the opponents as fast as possible. This looks like a dumb 50-50, but when you really think about it, he's getting the jump on his opponent and they have no idea what he's doing. So Savage isn't actually in that bad of a spot. From here, he manages his way out of the building and gets the knock on one of the opponents using a beautiful right-hand peek and manages to hit the other enemy pretty good as well. He runs away a bit and manages to pick up some more light ammo. From here, the enemy makes the deadly mistake of running up the stairs, where Savage uses the element of surprise, a nice right-hand peek, and some beautiful aim to finish off the kill. There's a lot we can learn from this clip. First, if it all goes bad in a fight and you have almost no hope, it's worth considering jumping on your opponent for the element of surprise. You can see how this works out for Savage in this clip, and it ultimately results in him picking up both of these kills. Alongside this, his right-hand peeks during this fight are flawless and are definitely something you should practice using in your fights, especially the way he uses stairs and walls from houses to peek around when he has no more materials. Overall, his strategy of surprising his opponents and his flawless right-hand peeks are what ultimately led Savage to winning this 1v2 fight, with the gray pistol, low materials, and no shield. Bravo, Savage. Bravo. This next Savage clip is a top 5 situation in a solo cash cup. In this clip, he's stuck far in the storm but has got 2 floppers. He spots a player on the edge zone and immediately realizes that his best chance to get back in the game is with an easy kill. Savage coming to get you, dude. Watch out. He scores about 60 damage on this player, but while he's popping a flopper, the player gets killed. Oh, kill steal. However, Savage sees the player who stole the kill doesn't have a wall on the side. Ooh, would you look at that? The way he realized this so quickly and was so fast to react and shoot his RPG is honestly remarkable. There's not much to that except for fast reaction time and knowing when to use his RPG, which is mainly something gained from experience. He quickly loots the player and tunnels into zone with good materials. It's now a top 2 situation. Savage pops a flopper fish to reach full health, and he makes a push for the height. He gets caught up in a box with his opponent, but take a look at this remarkable play that scores him the win. Savage places a trap on the floor, but realizes his opponent has placed 2 traps himself. Using sound and the process of elimination, Savage knows that one is on the roof and one is on the far side wall, so he heads back to the back corner to at least avoid the sidewall trap. From this point, he pulls a smart play of holding a ramp above him while he tries to replace it, but the opponent makes the smart play of exposing Savage to his roof trap. However, Savage takes this trade and he knows he'll survive with 10 HP remaining, and the opponent would have to expose himself to Savage's floor trap in order to have any chance of hitting him. So the opponent makes the not-so-smart decision to trade traps, at least considering he's fighting against Mr. Savage, and Savage cleans up with a kill with a crisp 120 pump shot to the face. From this clip, we can see Savage's amazing awareness and game sense, seeing players on edge zone to pick off for health, knowing when to pop his floppers, and seeing the tiniest opportunities to get shots off, like that RPG play earlier in the clip. Oh man, I'm gonna dream about that one. Woo, that was nice. Overall, this clip is amazing in showing Savage's superhuman awareness, and that's definitely one of the most important traits to have in order to pull off 200 IQ plays like he does. GG's only. Let's quickly recap everything we talked about. First, before the fight even starts, it's important to set yourself up for a good fight. Make sure you have good materials, loot, and preferably high ground as well before you engage on an opponent. Otherwise, you're basically setting yourself up for failure. Second, watching pros play, similar to how we did in this video, will help you learn some new tricks and tactics you can bring into your own fights. Third, gaining a fundamental understanding of game mechanics is super important as well. Understanding what works and what doesn't, and also knowing why things work and why they don't work. Come on, man, get it together! From Savage's gameplay, just from 2 30-second clips, we can learn quite a bit about making insane plays. First, using the element of surprise and jumping on someone can be a really helpful strategy if you're ever in a bad situation. And using natural right-hand peeks like stairs and windows can give you an unexpected advantage in early game. From the second clip, we can see how important it is to keep an eye on your health and time your healing correctly if you're in the storm, and how beneficial it can be to find picks on the edge of the zone. We can also see Savage's insane awareness come into play. Knowing where people are and what they're doing, along with his quick decision-making coming into play in the final fight, where he pulls out a deadly 200 IQ trap dodge, along with getting damage with his own trap and finishing the kill nice and easily. Yes, man, that was so freaking cool, dude. Thank you, Savage. Thank you. Overall, Savage is an insane player, and he's definitely one of the best players to learn from in terms of 200 IQ plays and such. By taking the tricks you learn from pro analysis, whether it's on your own or from our channel, along with learning more advanced game mechanics and setting yourself up for success in fights, you'll be well set up to pulling off some nasty 200 IQ plays just like you see streamers do. Thank you all so much for watching this video. We really hope it helped you out. If you enjoyed it, we'd appreciate it a bunch if you could drop a like, subscribe, and maybe even share the video with a few friends as well. Remember to tell us in the comments what you'd like to see next on the channel. We read all of your comments and we'll consider every idea. Also, be sure to check out ProGuides.com for some amazing exclusive content you won't find anywhere else. Once again, it's been your host, Cody. You can follow me on Instagram at CocoMedler. Thanks for watching, guys. Peace and love. Enjoy the new year. See you soon. Deuces. I'm gonna go back and watch that Savage clip. That was really nice, man. Okay, peace.